Documentary-type videos about video games are absolutely no stranger to YouTube. However, how many of them can say that they're as informative, insightful, and as visually appealing as Ahoy, or Xbox Ahoy, or Stuart Brown? I can't help but admire the execution of these videos because they're such a good example of keep it simple, stupid, for video editing. Before I get into that, though, I must give a brief overview of Ahoy. For the sake of this video, I will be talking about Stuart's contemporary work despite his massive back catalog. The reason for this is because of his emerging large-scale success of his recent work spanning from 2014 to now. There is absolutely nothing wrong with the videos before this, but this video would be horribly disinteresting if I just talked about Call of Duty gun guide videos. There's not really much to read into it, unfortunately. And yes, before you comment, I know he re-uploaded a lot of his Retro Ahoy series. I'll be talking about that too. As for the person behind the videos, you really can't say much besides that his name is Stuart Brown and he's from the United Kingdom, and that he makes insightful gaming content. A very accurate and simplistic message for his channel description. Now, the writing is something I'm not going to completely fawn over, because to me, I feel that Stuart's visual style is something that should be focused on more. Stuart's writing is great, but it's the presentation that gives it the weight. Like I said before, Stuart's editing style exudes the motto of keep it simple, stupid, especially in his videos 2014 and now. Stuart's visuals in his videos are extremely minimalistic but very thematic and appropriate. For instance, there is no overly complicated and flashy blueprint schematic shown in his iconic arms series. Instead, Stuart opts to use silhouettes and shapes against a monochromatic background. This aesthetic choice is not only unique but quite desirable and welcome, as it is humble and only wishes to visually convey a point instead of trying to seduce you with mind-blowing visuals. Intersplice this with a variety of gameplay footage with many games, and you got a well-crafted video that doesn't insult your intelligence. One of my favorite series from him is Retro Ahoy, not only because it strays away from his gun-centric content, but it allows him to shine when presenting thematics and references in his visuals. For instance, it seems every Retro Ahoy video that he does seems to have a variation of his logo that coincides with the style of the game he's talking about. I really love when creators do this specifically when they talk about media. They take the aesthetics of the game and blend it into their own video. Ahoy doesn't seem to sacrifice any of this identity while doing it, though. His most recent video, as of uploading this video, is about Polybius and is probably the best video on the subject at this point. Not only is it as long as a feature-length documentary, it brings the production value way up with the visuals and attention to mood setting. If you know the source material, you know Polybius is shrouded in mystery and speculation. Stuart made a great choice with the presentation in this video, and it shows that he is above the curve compared to his peers. Suffice to say, I heavily recommend this video just for its atmosphere. Something I'd like to note about Ahoy's videos is the great colors in the motion graphics. I may be the only one who noticed this, but I feel like the style is so reminiscent of old Atari boxes. It just reminds me a lot of the late 70s graphic design, with a modern edge to it. There's a deliberate use of colors. Stuart seems to understand very well how they can work thematically with each other. Like I said before, he doesn't try to have mind-blowing visuals and motion graphics. This is because Stuart's focus may be on better pacing. It's not over-cumbersome in its execution, and that's fine. There are minimal fancy transitions that insult your intelligence and take away focus from the video, something that I am even guilty of trying to do. I know I've mentioned this quite a bit about his editing, and we all know his videos are great visually. I feel many should take notes from Stuart. Mind you, I'm not saying you should copy his style, but take notes on the nuance of Ahoy's editing. I've become extremely critical of editing on YouTube, including my own and others. I'm seeing much more motion graphics and effects that aren't used effectively in a lot of smaller and bigger YouTubers. See my last video for more clarification about this. I'm a huge hypocrite when it comes to saying this, though, but I try my hardest to keep pacing in check, and I'm trying to evolve as much as possible. Now, I might just be digging way too deep into this. That might just be people's styles, but that's fine, but the craft is half the battle when it comes to editing. Ahoy may have his style, but in terms of execution, it's master levels of good. I feel if G4 was still around, this would be one of the series I would expect to be on the block of programming. It's that professionally done. Overall, Stuart's Ahoy is not only becoming one of my favorite channels, but one of my favorite editors. I admire his style and his work quite a bit, and so does the other million subscribers. Do I really have a good conclusion to this? Not really. Except, this is Blue Shades, and this was a video about Ahoy.